the judicial branch. This is a court system that interprets and applies laws when resolving some kind of dispute. Whether it is criminal, you broke the law, civil, I'm suing you, or administrative, who is in charge of this? The highest court is the Supreme Court. It has 9 members. They are nominated by the president and confirmed through majority vote in the Senate. After cases go through the lower court systems, when there's enough evidence that a particular case needs a ruling by a higher authority, well, not that high, the case can eventually reach the Supreme Court, where the court can rule that a particular law or the enforcement of a law is unconstitutional or not. In other words, there is a document called the Constitution that gives people certain rights, and no laws are allowed to be created that violate the rules in this Constitution. The members of the Supreme Court are the ones who have the final decision on whether laws that were created actually violate the Constitution. They can decide that the law is okay as written. They can throw out parts of a law or even the whole law if they think it's unconstitutional. So they have power over both Congress and the President, who write the laws and vote on them, by declaring these laws unconstitutional. In some cases, they can even rule on the way the President and the rest of his executive branch enforce the laws. On some controversial issues, where the vote is often 5-4, you can see that the court is divided by different ways that they interpret the Constitution. In fact, when they are divided 5-4, you can often see that those who are nominated by a Republican president tend to vote the same way as each other, and those nominated by a Democratic president tend to vote the other way. While there is not supposed to be any party affiliation on the Supreme Court, the reality of their voting shows some evidence that they tend to lean toward the party that nominated them. The Supreme Court members serve for their whole life or until they decide to retire, unless they are impeached for breaking the law or for inappropriate conduct. The House of Representatives can vote to impeach the Supreme Court members, which means send them to the Senate for a hearing, and the Senate can vote to remove that member or not with majority voting, although no member of the U.S. Supreme Court has ever been removed. Only a very small number of cases are heard in the Supreme Court. There are many other federal courts that make most of the rulings on federal laws, meaning those laws that are for the whole country. There are also state courts that rule on state laws, as well as city, town, and county courts that rule on laws made in those smaller regions. Every state organizes their courts slightly differently from each other, so it is hard to generalize on their organization. The judges in the lower courts are often chosen in elections, and since money can help the judges pay for commercials, the results of these elections can often be influenced by people who have money. The judicial branch is one of the 3 branches of the U.S. government. The design of the U.S. government system is to have a balance of power between the judicial branch and the executive and legislative branches so that no one branch can become too powerful. So you tell me, is the power in the U.S. balanced?